Tonight's session is about tips for treating piriformis pain. Now, I'm first going to look at the anatomy of the piriformis muscle and why it can cause trouble if it is in spasm or irritated. And then we're going to look at the five main tips that I have for people when they have piriformis pain, how they can get better. Okay, so my name is Maryke. I'm the physiotherapist from sportsinjuryphysio.com, where you can get online physiotherapy treatment for your injuries. I'll put a link to my website in the comments or in the description of this video as well. So let's jump right in and have a look at the anatomy of the piriformis. There we go. So what you're looking at there is the back of the leg, the buttock, the main muscle, the glute max, has been cut away, and you can see that little red muscle there is the piriformis muscle. Now, it's a tiny muscle in the buttock. You may think, what's the big issue with this? But now the next picture next to it, you can see there's a nice yellow line running down the leg, and that's your sciatic nerve. And because your sciatic nerve runs underneath or through or over, for some people, the piriformis muscle, when that muscle gets tight and sore, it can affect the sciatic nerve, and that can cause you a lot of pain in your buttock. But now the other thing that I want you to notice on that anatomy picture is how many other muscles are in close proximity to the piriformis muscle. You've got your glute med muscle, your glute min, you've got your glute max over the top, you've got your deep, your really deep buttock muscles, your obturator and your, I've forgotten their names now. Anyways, your really, really deep little ones. Then you've got your hamstring attachment to the ischial tuberosity, and you've got your IT band over the side as well. Now, any of those structures, if they are tight or sore, can affect your piriformis muscle. And also, because the structures that run over the lower back and the sacroiliac joint kind of comes into the fascia that surrounds the piriformis muscle, that can also affect your pain in that area. So that's worth keeping in mind when we move on to tip number one. Now, let me just get these in place. So tip number one is make sure you've got your diagnosis right. Because like I've just shown you there, there are quite a few other structures in the buttock that can cause pain in that area. And what I find in practice is that often a tight and sore piriformis is actually being caused by a lower back that's not happy, or sacroiliac joint, or injuries to some of the other muscles. Pure piriformis syndrome, which is a term that people like to throw around, is extremely rare. Now, piriformis syndrome is where just the piriformis muscle is extremely irritated or tight, and that clamps onto your sciatic nerve, causing pain down the back of your leg. Of course, yes, it does exist, but it's not as common as people like to diagnose. What I find is a clinician will find a tight and sore piriformis and say, oh, this is piriformis syndrome causing you your pain. But then actually, it's either the lower back or the sacroiliac joint or something else that's causing the piriformis muscle to be tight. And if you don't address those other issues and just hammer the piriformis muscle, it may not get any better because you're not actually taking care of the cause. So it's really important to understand what is causing your piriformis pain and your buttock pain so that you can apply the correct treatment. Now, let's just assume that you do have a piriformis muscle that's contributing to your pain. What can you do about it? So the second thing you can do is, let me just get that up. You can definitely use piriformis stretches, but also stretches for the rest of the muscles in the glute area. What I will say is, if your piriformis muscle is really irritated and the sciatic nerve is quite sensitive because it's now been squashed for a while, or it goes hand in hand with a lower back injury that may be sensitive, if you're going to do a strong stretch of your piriformis muscle, you may actually make it feel worse. So what I find in practice works well is if you do stretches, but do them to a very low grade, you just take it to where you can feel the first sensation of a stretch and you hold it there for a long period of time. Remember, with this type of thing, you've now got increased tone in your muscle. So the muscle tone is too much. You want to decrease it. So you want to deactivate the muscle. And to deactivate muscles, we've got to hold stretches for at least 30 seconds, but actually more than 45 seconds. So a very low grade stretch held for longer periods of time is much better. Now, if I can demonstrate one of my favorite ones, because it's not that extreme, let me just move my chair out of the way and I'll show you my favorite one. So one of the most common examples that people know is the pigeon stretch. But what I find with that is that you have to be in quite a contorted position to get the pigeon stretch right. And it is also quite difficult to kind of control how much force you put through it. So the one that I prefer is just you're lying on your back. And I just want to try and see what I'm doing. And you cross your one leg. So this will be the leg that I'm stretching. What you do is you cross it fully over and then you place one hand on your knee, other hand on the lower leg, and you pull with both of them to your opposite shoulder. So let me just move into the camera shot a little bit more that you can see it properly. So you cross your one leg over, one hand on the knee, other hand on the lower leg, and you pull across your chest. Now, I'm not pulling up to my opposite shoulder straight up, I'm pulling diagonally to my chest. I wonder if I lie this way around, if you can see it better. Let's see. So if you look at me from the back, yes, that will work. If I stretch this one now, you cross your leg fully, one hand on your knee, other hand on the lower leg, and you pull it up towards your opposite shoulder. There we go. So that would stretch my piriformis in this side. Now, if you're quite tight in the other gluteal muscles, you may feel a stretch if you bring it straight up. For me, that doesn't really stretch much. But if your whole buttock is tight, then that can be a useful stretch to do as well, just to bring it straight up. But if you want to get the piriformis specifically, then you've got to cross over and also pull with this hand down. And you don't pull as hard as you can. You just take it to where you feel the first stretch and you hold it there for 35 to 45 seconds. Okay. So that's my favorite stretch for the piriformis, purely because you can really control how much force you put through it. Okay, so if we move on, I'm actually just going to put my laptop on my lap. Let's see, what's tip number three? Tip number three is massage. Now, massage can be a really, really useful tool if you've got any type of buttock pain. But the same principle applies to this. If you're going to really hammer the piriformis muscle and it is already irritable and holding onto your sciatic nerve, you may very well make it worse. So it's got to be firm massage, but it should be comfortably uncomfortable. It shouldn't give you pins and needles or sharp pain down your leg when you're doing it. And that counts for if a massage therapist is doing it as well. It can be uncomfortable, but it's got to be comfortably uncomfortable. Otherwise, I've seen people get worse through massage for that. So if you want to apply it yourself, all you need is a nice firm ball. So I tend to use a tennis ball, purely because it doesn't really mark my walls that much. And again, you can do it on the floor, but I actually prefer to do it standing up against the wall. Now, let me just get this bit out of the way so that you can see properly what I'm doing. So what you want to do is not lose your ball. You want to be massaging that part of the buttock, okay? So your piriformis muscle lies kind of in that area, but you're going to go according to where you feel the discomfort against the wall. So what you do is you place the ball into there, and then you just relax and put your weight through it onto the wall. Now I want to get this camera a bit further so that you can see what I'm doing with my legs lower down as well. Let's see what you can see there. Okay, that's better. So what I'm doing is I am literally using my leg that's far away from the wall to push into the wall. But for this leg that's being massaged, where I've got the ball against the wall, I'm really just leaning with my body weight against that, and I'm trying to relax it so that I can really get into that muscle. Now, if you get it on the painful spot, again, it's going to be comfortably uncomfortable, and you just hold it there for a little bit. Again, you can hold it for about 30 seconds to 45 seconds, but you'll feel the pain decrease as you hold it there. And then you can move it on to the next bit. You can do the same thing on the floor by just leaning onto the floor on it, but I find that can be quite uncomfortable sometimes, and it's difficult to control how much pressure you put through it. But it would be in this position, and you'd angle yourself onto it. And there you can kind of feel that the discomfort is coming in. And you just hold the position again before you move on to the next. But remember, the piriformis can easily be irritated. So take your time and ease into it and feel that the pain disappears rather than get worse. Okay. Good. Then, let's see. Oh, get everything close again. Okay, so if we look at tip number four. And that's strength training. So when it comes to strength training, people often like to use exercises like the glam or side leg lifts. Now, I find if the piriformis is really irritated and you do a clam, when it gets into that shortened position at the top, it often just goes into spasm. So my patients react really well to just simple glute bridges at the beginning. And actually what the research has shown, if you do a glute bridge and especially a single leg glute bridge, you get a lot of activation in the piriformis muscle. So I usually find that that is a nice and easy way to start off with getting some blood supply through the piriformis. I also include like a spine curl into the bridge position so that they start mobilizing their lower backs. And if I think the main cause of the pain is actually coming from the lower back, that's a really nice combination where we can start addressing the lower back, but also getting circulation and things through the piriformis. So to show you what I mean with that, typical glute bridge or spine curl into glute bridge that I would do would be like this. It would just be the simple where you do a pelvic tilt and come up, and then you get to the top and you just squeeze your bum and you hold the position. But I'm not arching my back, I'm just squeezing my buttocks, squeezing my stomach and counting till 10. And then you roll back down again. Okay, so it's pelvic tilt, come up, hold the position and squeeze and come back down. And my patients really find that a lot more tolerable than trying to do clams or anything like that. Excellent. So that was tip number four, was strength training. Then lastly, be careful of hamstring stretches. Now, when we move, and especially when you take your legs straight out in front of you, you also move your sciatic nerve. Now, your sciatic nerve is meant to slide freely as you move. Imagine that piriformis holding on to it, so it can't slide. So if you do a hamstring stretch, you're going to stretch your nerve. And what happens then is you're irritated more. So especially if you're getting some pain down your leg, be careful with hamstring stretches. Don't do them in the first instance. Make sure that you loosen off your buttocks and things first, and then very gently start stretching it. Now, when you stretch your hamstring in these cases, you should either feel better or the same after you've stopped doing it. If it feels really uncomfortable after you've done it, then it's not the right exercise at the moment because the nerve is not free to slide. So work on the other bits first. But that's why it's useful to consult a physio or somebody similar so that they can look at what is your specific case, why your buttock is hurting, and then also when the right time is to implement all of these things. So the 5 points to remember is there are plenty of reasons why the piriformis muscle may be angry. Pure piriformis syndrome, where it's just the muscle's fault, is not very common. It's usually from a direct blow or something like that that gets irritated. It's more likely that it's your lower back or the sacroiliac joint or something else that you've injured that's contributing to this. Second is massage can be very useful. soak and stretching, but just not very hard either of those. You've got to ease into it very carefully. Strength training is useful as well. Glute bridge is a great place to start with that. And then be careful, don't do hamstring stretches necessarily at the beginning because it can make it worse. Rather go see somebody before you add that in. Excellent. Let me know if you've got any questions. I sincerely hope if I watch this back that there was sound on this video. But yeah, have a good evening. Take care.